was walking down a dark road, hard cold, all alone. I'm on my own, nobody better ask me for none. Remember we was sliding in that four door Audi. When it smoke, they get the high to make them scary boys run. Remember when I ain't have it, if I want it, I can buy it. I ain't bragging, I can go and blow it back just for fun. If we gon' keep it real, I took a lot of L's. I know pain, I went through hell, but I still came on number. I do my own stunts, don't need a backup. Tired of feeling broke, I got my racks up. These four pockets full won't fold on me. How you claiming you my dog and then you hold on me? Nowadays, they ain't showing real loyal. I was walking down the dark road, hard cold, all alone. I'm on my own, nobody better ask me for none. Remember we was sliding in that four door Audi. When it smoke, they get the high to make them scary boys run. Remember when if I want it, I can buy it. I ain't bragging, I can go and blow it back just for fun. If we gon' keep it real, I took a lot of L's. I know pain, I went through hell, but I still came out number one. I was walking down a dark road, hard cold, all alone. I'm on my own, nobody better ask me for none. Remember we was sliding in that four-door Audi. When it smoke, they get the high to make them scary boys run. Remember when I ain't have it, if I want it, I can buy it. I ain't bragging, I can go and blow it back just for fun. If we gon' keep it real, I took a lot of L's. I know pain, I went through hell, but I still came out number one.
Only religion was the moolah. Made a couple million, hallelujah. Daddy was a toy. Called a homeschooler. Never did homework. I was gone home with the work, no tutor. Used to have enough. Grew up with the hustlers and the killers. Now I'm kicking it with Puffy in the villa. Chillin', click full of zombies like Thriller. Got real, about to get real. That's just how I'm feeling.
I'm on one. My big box got me feeling so bossy. Like Lauren Hill, me I kill them softly. This a girl rather fi be called a naughty. Cause if my too loyal, then it's gon' cost me. And
that's just how I feel.
Yeah.
That's just how I'm feeling.
That's how I feel.
Dog, that's just how I'm feeling. When I touch down, I'ma burn it all to the ground. Make sure the whole world feel it. That's just how I'm feeling. Big boss, I'm a big boss. Up north, brick rocks. I got the pump that'll make you jump. Don't you ever get it crisscross. Don't you ever get it crisscross. Don't you ever get it crisscross. I got the pump that'll make you jump. Don't you ever get it crisscross. Bet against me, that's a big love. You about to find out what the call. I find, then I get low. Lift off, it ain't nothing to cut the off. Stop frying, don't let it get soft. Covered in yo, in yo. Wonder why I got the whole world pissed off. That's how I'm feeling. That's just how I'm feeling. Dog, that's just how I'm feeling. When I touch down, I'ma burn it all to the ground. Make sure the whole world feel it. That's just how I'm feeling.
If he has tried me, I shall come forth as pure gold. Have you been tried in the fire? Have you been tried in the fire? Well, tell me, did you come through as pure gold?
You kick it like- like the benefactor's benefactor. Well, truthfully, we know you never been a factor. Well, honestly, the truth is that you've been an actor. And now your actions got them boys about to mass up. Lectures from the devil got you piping hot. This up and you get screwed and chopped, no Michael Watts. When I was 10, I knew I should have been on Rap a Lot. Think like Jay Prince and I do more than just rap a lot.
Listen,
I went and got my digits up.
Listen,
your favorite, bruh.
Listen,
you don't want no trouble, cuh. The 25th, I got a meeting with the governor. That's real Rap a Lot, no cap a lot. I used to from Farron down to Camelot. I used to whip a in my granny's pot. She asked my friends, was I? They said, nope, he not. The mind to a praying woman. The truth's a heavy burden and it's weighing on me. Red Dog has caught me slipping with the wailing on me. I went to calling out for Jesus like a reverend on me. Chopped it up to sin, took it on my chin. Gotta take some L's if you wanna win. They took a but then take a sin. I didn't even have no re-up I could re-up with. Had to rob another just to re-up. Pray to God it in his heart, he found forgiveness for me. It was nothing personal, it was just business for me. When I got on, I paid him back and told him it was ugly. I'd rather ask forgiveness like 100 times than be asking for permission in a beggar's line. Cause of who I be and check out how I tend to mine. I got a partner who don't eat no poke at dinner time. But let you act like you gon' ever hurt or injure mine. He have your woman, and that's my dinner time. I keep my eyes on glory, tell the devil get behind. Now bear in mind the devil made me offers I decline. We not aligned, not combined, I am not confined to any wicked system that these demons have designed. They frame a mind and have you salty as a bacon rind. I'm trying to mastermind how to help out humankind. I'm open mind, but I do not rock with none aligned. My state of mind is to keep a peace for peace of mind. I'm like Malcolm with my piece at the Venetian blinds. I'm trying to manifest some things in my subconscious mind that I have only seen in dreams in my unconscious mind. My dreams unrefined, spring to mind, a state of mind that make it seem this lucky life of mine is pre-designed. And if it is, then thank the Lord, cause that's the mastermind.
This love, this love, this love.
Gotta make the right decision, no, it might just be my last. People view everything different when you touching on the back. What you say is good intentions, it's for clout and haters mad. You can never be a subject, carry, gotta wear a mask. They be pulling at you, grabbing at you, pop up trying to change you. I built my own foundation and there ain't no rearranging. Moving careful every day is exactly how I play this. Not looking for number one, but that's exactly how I'm placing. I got choices, I'm getting opinions from so many folks to bring the so I can get up away from all the noise. Too many people tell me what I should do. I take it in line. They not knowing if I mess up, I can end up falling flat. If I write a bad tweet, lagging in my whole street. If I give them what they wanted, I'm gonna be broke in a week. If I tell my baby no, she might get it from the street. If I'm not tough on my son, he might grow up to be weak. What do I do? I'm new to having cameras in my face. What do I do to keep getting the love from my state? What do I do to keep the money coming in? What do I do? Writing until I need another pen. Gotta make the right decision, no, it might just be my last. People view everything different when you touching on the back. What you see is good intentions.
EA Sports coverage of the NFL playoffs brings us to the Pacific Northwest, the home of the 12s, and they are in full roar. Sports coverage of the NFL playoffs brings us to the Pacific Northwest, the home of the 12s, and they are in full roar as you get a look inside Lumen Field in Seattle. Straight ahead, we pull the curtain on the postseason with an NFC wildcard matchup between the Tampa Bay Buccaneers and the Seattle Seahawks. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. This is the Oklahoma State alum, Chris Carson. And not a whole lot of room to operate there on the first down run. He gets maybe three.
Yeah, I don't know if it's exactly a win-win, but if you're on offense, you'll take that kind of a run, all right? It was kind of stacked up, found a little bit of yardage, and frankly, they're pretty close to staying on schedule on offense. The playbook is still open for the coordinator.
Here's second and seven now from the 28. Now a play fake, and here's Locke. Catch is made by Metcalf. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds.
Time to give some credit to the big fellows, the offensive line here, because you've got to have good protection on crossing routes, because you've got to give your receiver time to work all the way across the field. That time, able to scan the field, spot his receiver moving left to right, and make a good, accurate throw. Thank you, guys.
So from Buccaneer territory now, it's first and 10 at the 47. And he sneaks his way forward only for a couple here, second down.
Well, any lane that might have been open there was closed pretty quickly, and that was because the defensive front, they won that battle at the point of attack at the line of scrimmage. They used great leverage, held their spot, and stacked him up.
Second and eight. Play action. Now it's Locke. Oh, he tries to get it to Metcalf, but it's intercepted. Picked off by Adrian Phillips. And they finally put an end to this return, but not before he's all the way down to the 37. Nobody ever wants the interception on the opening drive to happen, but when it happens in the playoffs, it feels like it's a bigger deal. What a rough start.
And how about these visitors? The defense just went right on the field and seized momentum. You know, almost like they're saying, okay, no one expects us to win this one. Let's go ahead and give them a shock early. Took the ball from the home team and put them in the hole.
Because this crowd, one of the best in the league, especially this time here, it's going to be tough to take them out of it, but that's a heck of a start. That throw by Brady, incomplete.
Well, defensively, you're over there trying to catch your breath and try not to show the offense that you're a little bit fatigued. You're right back out there after the turnover. Now they've got to work towards getting another couple of stops and forcing them into at least a long field goal situation.
Throwing again on second and 10. Brady, rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. Picked off by Sidney Jones. Well, a shaky start for both quarterbacks now. We had the interception on the opening drive, and now they throw it right back to him.
So does that mean we're really kind of starting from the beginning, Brandon, right? Both of them have done it, so we kind of start from scratch. Looks to me like both of these defenses have done their homework, and they're executing quite well.
They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40. The improv on the scramble there gets him six, and it'll be second down. Play action, Locke. Open man, that's Noah Fant, the tight end. He's going to go out of bounds, but he takes this one down just shy of the 20.
Good job there of getting his tight end involved because he lines up on the right side of the formation, just works his way across the field. I really like how they were in sync on that one. He spotted the open gap in the zone, and his quarterback found him, and they get a first down.
First and 10, and they've got three tight ends out there. A jumbo package look. Now a handoff as they run left side. And he'll go out of bounds in the red zone just inside the 20. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
They did a really nice job there defensively. They strung the play out, didn't give him a cutback lane. On each play, you have guys what I call our BCR players. Guys are responsible for the bootleg, for the cutback, and for the reverse. They played that one perfectly.
And rode him right out of bounds. On second and 7, Lock, and he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. Now on 3rd and long, they'll look to throw. And he'll be out of bounds just inside the 25-yard line. 5 yards that time out of the scramble. But now they're looking at a fourth down situation. Now here's Jason Myers. He gets set for the Seahawk field goal. From the right hash, it's a 41-yard attempt. And Myers able to knock it through. And the Seahawks grab a 3-0 lead. So the turnover leads to points as they add 3 there.
Yeah, what a sequence there and a nice one for them. They force the interception, put together a little drive, and then come away with 3 points. Nothing to it, partner. Just do it.
The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. They threw an interception the first time they had the football, only gave up 3 points off of that, so it shouldn't be a difficult hole to overcome.
It really shouldn't, as long as they're not listening to the chatter coming from the other side, because when you throw a pick, look, I know defensive backs, they have a tendency to be a little bit loud after they take one away, but they also have a tendency to gamble a little bit more, thinking they'll get a second one. Maybe they can take advantage of that with some double moves.
Now a throw here to his running back. That'll go for a gain of 7, and it'll bring up a second down.
Just about every quarterback is trained to really look downfield first before you come back and make a nice, safe throw. And in this case, that's exactly what he did. Found his running back, let him create some space, and it turned out to be a nice play for the offense.
Pressure comes. He's taken down by the Seahawks defense. So Brady and the Bucs need to work a little magic. 3rd and long after that last sack. Looking for Evans, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Jamal Adams. And the return this time will go out to the 42-yard line. And not the first quarter that he was hoping for. Now 2 interceptions thrown.
Well, the good ones, they find a way to compartmentalize, right? Put these behind them, have that short memory, but understand why they threw the 2 interceptions. They go on and usually play a pretty decent game. Other quarterbacks, they have a hard time getting past it and often put the ball up for grabs the rest of the ball game.
And that is incomplete. Oh, the coverage a little too good there, and it's second down.
That was nice work there defensively to force the incompletion. Now, even though this drive started in plus territory, they're still not in field goal range yet. So they can work towards another couple of stops and not allowing that turnover to hurt.
2nd and 10, a very chilly day here, but no snow. And I got to say, if it's going to be this cold, I want snow. You should see Charles' face. He's looking at me like I'm crazy. Eluding the pressure right. Past the 20. And he's brought down after a very nice game.
We talk about mobility on quarterbacks all the time. Here's where it really pays off. Able to move, evade, and his accurate throwing on the run and picking up a first down.
Clock running, under a minute to go now here in a fast-moving first quarter. Lock now on first down, out to his left. And he wisely will throw that one away.
Oh, I like that right there. Not only was it the right play, throwing it away like that, frankly, I think it was the only play.
Yeah, got outside of the pocket, realized he had nothing, just chucked it free.
Yeah, live to fight another down, right?
Here's second and 10. Again, it's Locke. He'll find Metcalf. 5 yards. Now it's third and 5.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you've got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go because he might wander into some tough coverage.
On third down, Carson. And they'll get him down about 3 yards short of the first. 2 yards on the pick up there. It's fourth down.
A 2 yard gain. It's fourth down.
Three nothing after one on EA Sports. And no signs of the field goal unit. They're going for it on fourth down. They'll go for it. It's Locke. He's going to have his running back. It's complete. And the Seahawks are going to have first and goal as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points. Both sides were holding their breath there on that fourth down play, and the offense can breathe a sigh of relief.
And both knew exactly where the first down markers were. You know the defense is trying to guard those sticks and try and keep people in front. But somehow, some way, those guys found a way to pick it up.
I'm going back to you. He's coming.
They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And he is in for the Seattle touchdown. Chris Carson, a 6-yard touchdown run. And the Seahawks add on to their lead. Myers connects on the PAT, and the lead grows to 10-0. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. To this point, the results have not been good. 2 possessions, 2 turnovers.
And that's obviously something that can't continue, but to go a little bit deeper on that one, I would think about some play calls now, not even necessarily to my best player, but to someone I can trust with the ball, try and get things settled down a little bit. And what a nice example there of a tight end doing exactly what he needs to do. How about how he worked his way to the outside, made sure he secured the catch, and then anything after that, we count that as a bonus. And indeed, he gets enough for the first down.
Now Brady gets away with one. Lucky could have been intercepted, but it falls to the ground. So he's 3 for 7 throwing the football right now. Not an awful start, but also not the sharpest of starts.
No, I would agree with that. But if you're a confident quarterback and to play that position, you have to be. You just act like there's something wrong with the wind currents or something wrong with the ball. It is not you. Keep throwing. That timing usually develops.
Meanwhile, the throw here is complete. 5 yards. Now it's 3rd and 5. Brady to throw again. Going for Burton, and he's got it. And he'll be out just 1 or 2 shy of the 30.
Normally on 3rd down and short yardage, you're thinking to throw to your tight end. It's just going to be a simple chain mover. But this time they let him roam down the field, and a nice dart picks up the 1st down and then some.
Brady's throw there complete. And he's got this down almost to the 20 before he's dropped. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. To throw, it's Brady. And seeing no options, he just tosses this one away incomplete. Now that'll bring up second down.
Well, Charles, you talk about this offense, and you think about the man in charge, their head coach, this marking his first ever playoff game as the head coach, and you wonder what's going through his mind right about now.
Brandon, I think we both agree that he's had a great season, and we wouldn't be surprised at all to see him get plenty of Coach of the Year votes. I thought he took the right tone in his weekly press conference, though. Played it cool, took the reserved angle, and when you don't have the track record, I think that's the exact right way to do it.
Now Brady again. And it's caught. And in for the Buccaneers touchdown. Giovanni Bernard, a 16-yard touchdown. And the Bucs have made this a one-score game. Extra point put through by Succop, and the lead is down to a field goal. Now it's Ryan Succop on after the touchdown to kick it away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline, because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
Following the incomplete pass, here they go again, second and 10 from the 25. They fake the handoff, now Locke. To the right side, incomplete to Metcalf. And out of bounds on the other side of midfield at the 45. A big connection on that one, 30 yards. So the big play moves them all the way across midfield. It's first and 10 from the 45. And they'll run on the inside handoff. He takes this for about six down inside the 40.
A nice run right there. And we talk this time of year about certain teams, certain players who don't have a lot of postseason history to speak of. And here's a man right here in his rookie season in the NFL, and he's being asked to carry the load at running back for this offense.
And he has acquitted himself nicely here in his rookie year. And look, I think we both believe that the burden's a little lighter on backs and receivers than it is on quarterbacks in the playoffs. But that's not to say this is going to be easy. As fast as the NFL game is in the regular season, it's like warp speed when you turn pressure up in the postseason. So let's see how he handles things early.
And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. They'll say no gain on the play there, and now it'll be third down. And he got off the end there very quickly to make that play.
Yeah, it was almost like the bullet train, wasn't it? I mean, just zoom, quick, 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 and what a terrific play, holding them to no gain.
A reminder coming up at the half, as we've done all year. We'll get you to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. Coach will have the lowdown on what's going on here in this wild card weekend as we begin on the road to Super Bowl 53 in Atlanta. And he is going to have a Seahawks first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
Another catch for him there on this drive, Brandon. And it looks like they're going to utilize him out of the backfield any way they can. And that time they pick up a first down. So now on defense, do you assign a man to him and try and cover it before he gets going?
Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. Block off a play action. They'll roll him out right. And he'll protect himself at the end here as he winds up getting pretty decent yardage. Nice work to get seven out of that, and it's second down.
Partner, he was going through his progressions. Not there, not there. After about the third one, he decided he better pull it down and run for it. And he slides down and avoids the hit for good measure.
3 yards remain for second down. From the gun, they'll try to run it. And this won't be enough to pick up the first. A gain of 2, third and 1.
And the big fella stuffed that one up in a big way. I think doubling him has to be a priority because you can't move up to the next level if you don't take care of him first.
This will be play number 7 on the drive, 3rd and 1. Now a handoff here to his running back. And he will have the first down across the 20 to the 19-yard line.
Each team has its own terminology. Some people call it jumbo, some call it monster, some call it king. But it doesn't really matter. They brought in the big lumber to pick up that first down.
Yeah, you think about goal line defense with the goal line offense that time getting it done. So here's a 1st and 10 now down inside the 20. Now Locke. Fighting to stay upright. And that throw behind his man. He missed him. Incomplete.
They certainly thought they had him surrounded and probably thought they were going to get him on the ground and get the sack, but he was able to elude that. And even though it threw it incomplete downfield, if you're a defensive back, you're loving the pressure that you're seeing from your front.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a 2nd and 10. Now it's Carson. And he's going to push his way down to about the 12. Now the Seahawks call the 2nd of their 3 timeouts as they stop it with 28 seconds to go in the first half of play. Locke going to try and throw on 3rd down. To the goal line, but it's incomplete.
That's an excellent play by the defender. He diagnosed that one, closed quickly, and helped force the incompletion.
So 2 3rd down conversions on this drive, but not able to get a 3rd, and now they deal with 4th down. Meyer's kick is good, and the lead stretches to 6 here. It's 13-7. No problems in the field goal department so far. He's 2 for 2.
Pretty reliable here in this game, isn't he? And to me, that bodes well for them. If they need him late in the game, his confidence should be sky high.
And this will be a touchback as Ed sails over the end line. Offense set to begin their next possession, and they'll take over with just 18 ticks remaining. Looking downfield for Godwin, and this one is incomplete.
Certainly no lack of aggressiveness here. They were hoping for the home run play to get them 6 points. They're hoping for a catch, maybe a call, but they figure they can at least get into field goal range with a completion.
So the incompletion, and now it's 2nd and 10, again from the 25-yard line. Working from the gun, it's Brady. Gets it to his running back, Bernard. And they work this well upfield across the 45. Now whistles and a timeout with 3 seconds left in the first half. And you see the clock almost empty, so this is likely the last play in the 2nd quarter. The final shot before half for Brady. Flushed out right. Bears it out toward the corner of the end zone. And it's intercepted at the goal line. Picked by Kevin Byard. And he will be brought down on what will be the final play of this first half. So we come upon halftime here in this NFC wild card matchup as we send you cross country to Orlando. Jonathan Coachman is there and has our EA Sports halftime report.
Plenty of adjustments likely being made by both teams in their respective locker rooms to find out who advances to the divisional round. Let's get you back out to Brandon Godd.
All right, Coach, thanks. Yeah, both teams likely to make some changes in what's been a closely fought battle to this point. One of these two teams about to play their final half of the season as we're back at it in this NFC wildcard bout. And he will be brought down here inside the 20. Good coverage as he's dropped at the 17. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And Charles, that had to be an interesting locker room at halftime. This is a team that's had so much success this year. Haven't really had to deal with a lot of adversity at halftime, to be honest. But now here they are with their playoff lives on the line.
And I think when you're alluding to that interesting locker room, you're just wondering, how are they handling that bit of adversity that they're seeing right now? Because I think this is a team that has to look to lean on the veterans at this point. We know we're better than this. We've proved it all season. Let them disseminate that confidence through the locker room. But this opening drive, it'll be an important one for them to give them a little jolt of confidence moving forward. A couple of first downs right in succession, and this is an offense that could really use a good drive, and they're off to a fast start here.
On first and 10, here's Brady. Flush to his right. And he's left with no option here but to throw it away. The passing windows are just not there. That's just another example of how great this defense has been all game long.
And that's exactly what a top 10 defense can do. They can really change the game tempo and frustrate you as you try to execute offensively.
Brady again here on second and 10. And that'll wind up moving the chains again as the tackle's going to be made at the Seahawks 22-yard line.
I love the drive they're working on here because they know they can take the lead with a touchdown. And so far on this drive, so good. They've moved the ball down the field with very little resistance defensively. But they better be prepared for some adjustments to come their way now.
And they'll get this down to the 10.
It's taken a while for this offense to get going. A little creaky at the start, but they're oiled up now. A nice throw there, and they're really putting together a good drive.
Throwing on first down is Brady. Escaping the pressure right. And he can't find anywhere to go with it. And he goes down. First down, a bit of a disaster. And now on second and goal, back even further. Shotgun now for Brady. And Evans hauls it in. Touchdown, Bucs. Mike Evans. There to make the grab. And the Bucs are just an extra point away from grabbing the lead now. Extra point up and good by Succop. And that will put them on top here in the third. Now it's Ryan Succop on after the touchdown to kick it away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Here's the Seattle offense ready to get this drive underway. And they'll be working from behind now following the touchdown a moment ago on the opening drive of the half.
I think the guys right now, as they go out on offense, they're zeroing in on one big key. They don't have to do anything differently just because they're down on the scoreboard now. The intent, still the same in what they plan to do on offense.
They'll contain him to just 4, second down. The gun, he'll hand this off into the secondary past the 40, and he'll get this all the way up to the 42-yard line.
That's
pretty much meat and potatoes right there, wasn't it? Just go right at them and let your big horse charge up the middle. Not too fancy there, was it?
Nothing fancy at all. Challenging that defense, and on that go-around, the offense won the challenge. You can just kind of sense the momentum turning here. It's first and 10. Now a play fake, and here's Locke. Finding a safety valve here. That's complete. 3 yards the gain there, second down.
I know it was a gain, but you have to sense probably a little bit of disappointment there, because when it's out there in open space, I think they expect to get more out of a play, don't you?
Especially when you're getting it to your guy out of the backfield. You're expecting him to be able to create something, be a little more shifty.
Yeah, no doubt about it. Good open field tackling held it to an okay game. That was an excellent job of recognizing the situation. His first read wasn't there. Heck, his second read wasn't there. But he bought himself a little extra time scrambling out of the pocket, got to the sticks, and picked up the first down.
So from Buccaneer territory now, it's first and 10 at the 45-yard line. Play action. Now it's Locke. Rolling to his right. And he'll just get rid of it. Got out of the pocket. Didn't look like he had anybody open, Charles, so just gets rid of it.
And a good play by him. If no one's open and you don't have a running lane that you want to take, make the right choice. Get rid of it. Live to fight another down.
Third quarter, wild card round. Thanks for being along for the playoff ride with us. Here's second and 10. They get six. That'll leave them with third and 4.
And there's a run to be happy with. Good, solid yardage. He'll take that anytime you hand the ball to a back.
Hands it off out of the gun. And he won't be close to a first down as he runs into a wall right around the line of scrimmage. Call it no gain there, and it leads to a fourth down. So on is Jason Myers. He's hit from as long as 58 in his career. This will be from 56 yards out. And this kick is not going to be close. It's well short, well right to boot. And this score will stay right where it is. Down here in the third quarter, obviously that's one they could have used.
Yeah, and one of my favorite special teams coaches in the NFL told me what separates the kickers in the NFL versus the ones who are not is not the misses. It's the second miss in a row. Best kickers in the league, they don't miss two in a row. He's got to get his head back together in case he gets another shot.
A big play that time through the air. 30 yards.
You ask tight ends about their favorite routes to run, and surprisingly, this will pop up as one of their staples because they run so many routes in the middle of the field. How about this one? Starts downfield, bends it to the corner. Great touch on the football, and they took
touchdown. It's complete. Trey Burton. A 24-yard touchdown. And the Bucs are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. Extra point put through by Suckup. And the lead is up to 8. Now it's Ryan Suckup on after the touchdown to kick it away. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. Now they had compiled a pretty long drive last time. Unfortunately, though, it ended with no points after the missed field goal.
And that can hurt the psyche of a team, because as they drove downfield, you know you're never supposed to count points in your mind until they go up on the board. But let's face it, we've been there, we've seen teams before. They were counting on those points. They didn't get them. Can they come back now, start over again, and grind it out?
Thank you. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. And now here's a carry heading left. And he takes this up right near the 45-yard line. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a second and 3.
Well, no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it, 7 yards on first down, that fits the bill.
A good run, got 7 on first. Here's second and 3. They look to throw. It's Locke. He's got his big tight end, Fant.
That was a route run, not just with dexterity, but with intelligence. Found the hole in the zone, made sure the quarterback saw him, and was able to make the sure catch and put the down marker back to 1.
So from Buccaneer territory now, it's first and 10 at the 46. Now they try the right side here. Room here to run. He'll get this one down near the 20-yard line, just shy of the 20. 61 yards on the ground for him now on 9 carries.
They're making it look easy out there. Another first down. So far on this drive, let me do this little bit of math here. 4 plays, 3 first downs.
That's a pretty good recipe for success. Play action, lock. End zone caught. Touchdown, Seattle. A great play there. There to make the grab. And the Seahawks have a chance to tie things up as they trail by 2 here in the 4th. So part 1 of what they needed is done. They get in the end zone. Now you have to imagine we'll see a try for 2.
And that's what the book says, but defensively, they can't hang their head right here. They still got a chance to come out with the lead if they make a play.
The Lock going to try and throw for it. And he's got it. The conversion good, and we are tied in the 4th. Still time to work with on the clock, but they wanted the tie now, and they got it.
And I love their aggressiveness. Go ahead and get it done. Get the game tied. Now your team has the momentum, and you're staring across the field saying, let's see if you can match us.
And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And it's all on the line now, all even in this wild card matchup. Maybe their most important drive of the season coming up right now here, first and 10. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line.
And partner, in a tie game in the 4th quarter, you and I both know in the NFL, that's when you lean on your stars, and he came through with a nice catch right there.
Fournette, a first down carry. And he's going to take this one up only to about the 44-yard line. But Jordan Brooks on the tackle.
Defensively, we always know that he is tough and run support. And I think the way that he gets there is he understands what an offense is going to do before the ball's even snapped. A great job of scouting prior to the game, then reading, reacting, and taking the right path to the ball carrier.
And he'll work it across midfield inside the 45.
Nice job, nice patience right there. Put him on the right side, let him work his way across, put the ball in his hands, and let him work his way upfield with a catch.
So from Seahawk territory now, it's first and 10 at the 44-yard line. From the gun, it's Brady. He's got Burton here. And some space here. And he's out of bounds, almost gets to the 10. A big connection on that one, 32 yards.
There's another big play for him right there, and that's not the first time we've said that throughout this game. This last catch puts him over 200 yards receiving for the ball game and leaving the defense with just one word in their mind, helpless.
Brady now on first down. And he hauls it in for the Buccaneer touchdown. The fourth touchdown pass of the game for Tom Brady. And the Buccaneers answer back with a touchdown of their own to break our tie and take the lead here in the fourth. Extra point up and good by Succop. And they will take a 7-point lead. Succop on after the touchdown to kick it away. This taken in at the goal line. And he'll be brought down right on the chalk of the 20. Here's the Seattle offense ready to get this drive underway. If they want to advance in this divisional round, look, obviously the time is now. Trailing here in the fourth as they go to work on a crucial, crucial drive, first and 10. 70 yards on the ground for him so far.
Playing against a 3-4 front is really challenging for offensive linemen because they can do so many different things. But when you're running the football, if you can handle the nose tackle up front and it may be a guard can slide up to the second level and block a linebacker, that's when you have success running the football.
And he'll give it here to his running back. And some room to work. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line.
Oh, that's one to warm the hearts of all those old school football players, isn't it? Tough, hard, gritty run, got behind his pads, bowled over a few people. Look at that one, right up the gut.
Saw it through three quarters, no reason to lighten up now. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a one-score game. So it's Seahawk football as we march toward a conclusion. They come up on a first and 10, desperately needing a score here on what could be their final drive. Now he's going to swing this one out to his running back. Call it a gain of 6 on the play, and it'll be second down.
Not in a position where they absolutely have to rush right now, but they definitely have to pick up the tempo a bit.
This will go to Carson out wide. And he'll be taken down at the 44-yard line. They're making steady progress, but I see your face. You're worried about that clock.
I'm worried about the clock, and at some point, you have to have a splash play in there as well.
The drive continues as they search for a tying touchdown. Here's first and 10. Rolling to his left. This is the tight end fan. A gain of 6 there on first.
And remember, field goal does them no good in this situation.
You got to think they should be taking some shots for the end zone soon. On second down, it's Carson. And he'll take this one down to the 36. Now the Seahawks going to use the first of their timeouts as they stop it here with just under 40 seconds to go in the game. So third and 2, and I count 6 defensive backs out there. Check 26, check 26. They stay on the ground. Again, it's Carson. And they'll get this one to about the 20-yard line. Now the Seahawks call the second of their three timeouts as the clock will stop with 33 seconds remaining. Lock to throw. Eluding the pressure right. And he's got the hook up here. Complete. Now lock. Got a man and he hits him in stride. Now the Seahawks forced to use their third and final timeout as he'll stop it with 11 seconds remaining in the ball game. A looming decision to make on the conversion, down seven, but first things first, they need to score as they come up on first and goal. He'll buy some time right. It won't be a sack, but it's no gain, and it brings up second down.
Well, he strung it out as far as he could, and I like the fact that he kept his eyes downfield, but he finally ran out of time and room. But I'll take that over forcing it downfield and possibly having it intercepted.
On second down now, it's Carson, and he will push his way forward down to about the 3-yard line. The second down play, not much better than the first, just a gain of one there. They said beginning of the season they wanted to get past the wild card round. Well, they just got past the wild card round.
How about that, being able to put the big check marks up in the locker room, right? Yeah, you know, get to the wild card game, check, got that done. Win a wild card game, big check. Now you've got to go ahead and set your sights higher. There is a bigger prize out there, and they still have an opportunity.